Hey, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. 2016 Chevrolet Colorado. This one here is the V6, the 3.6 liter V6. I had a truck over here a couple weeks ago, a week ago, I don't know, don't remember, don't matter. Actually, I made a little bit of a video. And what I made the video for is how to remove this this whole entire cap up on top of the engine. This here cap, that's not just a cap, that's also your air intake plenum, whatever you want to call that. Okay, so note, when you undo these, there is a screw here, let me get you in, which they broke off. They did not know, and my point here is, whoever had it off, they did not know how to do it. There is a screw here. There's an access hole on the other side. Same here, access hole for a screw, which was missing. Same here on this side, access hole for a screw right there. This is your filler cap for the oil, it has to come out. They pried the emblem off. They broke it. This is really attached with, I mean, it's glued on there or whatever they do to it, but They pried it. They thought that may have been the access point. So they busted this one here. In any event, what you got to do, and once you look at this like this, it's clear to you. It sits on the engine. I'm going to hold it this way, so you could actually see. It sits on the engine like that. So you reach down below. You reach through here to get to this hose clamp. You got to reach down through here to get to this hose clamp. Otherwise, you will break something off or whatever damage can be done. But anyway, I want to see if I find some screws for that. That was really the main reason why I turned the camera on, to share this with you, how to take these covers off without damaging what they did here. As unfortunately, GM thought that was a good idea to have a design like that, which is, well, never mind that. That's really why I turned the camera on this here. I was kind of a little bit in a hurry. Probably shouldn't have been. But anyway, I did replace the EVAP Purge solenoid. So, the EVAP Purge solenoid, it was wide open, it stuck open, so no good. when we unplug it, it's just a 2-wire. When we unplug it, that thing needs to be closed. Sorry, I try to gather my thoughts here to see how I'm going to go about doing this. Check engine light still on. EVAP large leak, it's still present. We had some lean codes, lean code since, of course, they cleared because we replaced the purge solenoid. I ended up having to smoke this truck because I looked at some scan data. It was pulling it down as far as the bi-directional control and the scan tool. It was pulling it down into a vacuum, but it wasn't pulling it like it should have, so I had to smoke the system, and I'm going to go through here. Now, this here is the charcoal canister. This is the lid that goes in the front of it. There is a sponge in here before you put the lid on.
So the way this works is these solenoids here, they just twist, pull out. I'll do it here in a minute. So this slips in, push this retaining lock, and you should be able to pull it right out of the frame. I'll show you that in just a minute. Bear with me. So I use the scan tool, bidirectional control, to close this purge valve. And what that does, give me a second here. Go ahead, pull this out one more time. So this is the old one, by the way. There's two O-ring seals, one here, one up top, one on the bottom. And the camera won't see it, but in here, there's basically a chamber that goes through the charcoal canister, which one of them being input, or not input, but the small one being the vapor line coming from the front, from the engine, and the bigger one here goes to the tank. Now you say, but there's a third one. You're correct. There is one more right here. This one is a hose, that's the equalizer hose that sits up, in this particular case here, it sits up close to the filler cap, filler neck, and that basically vents the tank and all that good stuff. It's vented through it. I'm not going to really go into detail. So what this amounts to is the solenoid here is actually clicking, but I don't know if it's actually closing the system off. Now, this vehicle has been messed with, so I don't know. They broke some of the clips on the electrical connection and all that good stuff. I don't know what the deal is with it. It's been an ongoing problem for the customer, so hopefully I can resolve this once and for all now. I did source a canister purge valve. I did source one of them. New one, of course. I'm going to go ahead and raise the truck up right now, and I'm going to show you where it lives, and I'll show you the hose that vents to atmosphere. I actually changed my mind before we do all that. So basically, I'm going to hook this up to the power supply and redo that test that I did yesterday. We take this here smoke machine and see if we can hook it up right here. Got to be careful not to spread that too much. I don't need to be getting carried away with it. So I'm going to turn that on for a small amount of time. Probably help if I turn the air on. Okay, turn the air on. My God. Got everything hooked up. So, I'm going to go ahead and actually I'll get a plug. So, all right. Give that smoke machine a whirl. There you go. Smoking through it, no problem. We'll close this off. Now that's closed off, we should be going to our vent area. Turn that smoke on. Oh, I hope that you can pick it up. Smoke is coming out of a vent area. So, now the problem I was having with it, now, I did mess around with this solenoid. So, I'm going to state right off the bat, if for some reason that is working now, we are not using this because I've been messing with this. It will fail. I'm going to do it like this, see if that shows up a little bit better. Backwards. See if it shows up a little bit better. Now, one more time. Turn the smoke machine on. Clearly see some smoke coming through there. Now, I'm going to energize the solenoid. Solenoid clicked. Solenoid is energized. Turn the machine back on. Now, I don't know how good the camera is going to pick that up. It does stop a lot of it, but it's still smoking some. But like I said, bear in mind, I did mess with that solenoid. It is still smoking out of there. It's just not a whole lot in any event. This is going to get replaced, so that one is actually working somewhat right now. But it's still leaking. No. It's still filling up the chamber somewhat. Like I said, I don't know how good the camera can pick it up, but anyway, it does leak a little. No. I did go ahead, clean the face, lubricate the O-rings and all that good stuff. Like I said, we are not putting that solenoid back in. It will fail just like it did before. New part. Put lubrication, some grease or something like that on it. I'm using the spray red grease. You would not want to get carried away with your grease though on that, on the solenoid, because remember, dust does get into that system and that will stick to it. So kind of keep that in mind. Oh, sorry, I almost forgot. What I did, where the solenoid goes, the hole, I get these brushes at Harbor Freight. I went ahead and cleaned all that up and brushed all the crap out of it. Go ahead and all right, good, nice, solid click on that. Go ahead and turn the smoke machine back on. I don't know if we can, maybe, probably should have done that a minute ago, but anyway, it doesn't matter. I think the camera seen the smoke regardless. Alright. So, as you can see, this time we have no smoke at all. Undo the wire. There goes the smoke. Go ahead and close that off. So, solenoid closed at this point in time. No more smoke. Again, take the power away from it. and you hear it snap.
Wrong way, fella. Yeah. So.
So I'm gonna get ready, put this back together. Well, heck, we'll do it right now. He said, don't forget to put your sponge back in here. And make sure your seal is actually going to seal. Looks like this one here is going to. Well, actually, looks like somebody had it apart and twisted it. Somebody definitely had that apart and twisted it all up. Camera will never pick that up. I don't know what happened here, but somebody messed around. I don't like it. We'll pause that camera up and see if that's something that we can actually get. I don't much like the fact that it is twisted, but there's no availability for it, so I have no choice but to reuse it. I would suspect that it will seal it. Wrong way again, fella. Yeah, it crushes it pretty good. I don't know what happened there, but anyway, it seems to be sealing it okay. So, figured I'd bring you along on that one too. So everything is good. We replaced obviously our canister vent valve, so let's hit to the or underneath the truck. Pause the camera up for just a second while I do that. Actually, firstly, let me show you this. So what we found right away, the vent is mounted in this area. Well, there's a hole, drain hole right here. It immediately come pouring out of that. The next thing you know, it came out of the fender wells. So I'll show you that. Finish going up with the truck here. Before I go up too high, let me show you this. So, yeah, make sure you can see it. Get you in there. In the event that you cannot slip the canister out of there because they get stuck pretty good,
the bracket is in this area here. Where my hand is, these holes right here in the frame, right where the where one of the cab mounts is at. You reach through there. There is a 13 millimeter nut. Actually, it's an M8, but you know we always give you the wrench and socket sizes. But anyway, you reach through here. You don't have to unbolt it. All you got to do is loosen it, and the whole bracket will slide off. Now moving on. Friggin' cables. Get you underneath. Get you underneath. So, is that light in a good position? No, it's not. Let's see. Can we do better? Can we do better? That may be better right there. Alright. There is our electrical connection. Like I said, two wire. Same difference what I did a while ago. Up here is the bracket. Like I said, you should be able to get it out of there, but you may not be able to slide it out. And before you break the locking tab, I would suggest go ahead and slide the whole entire bracket off of there. Easiest thing to do. Green. In this case, get you up just a little bit more. Okay, green in this case here. That's goes straight into the tank. And this here, more flexible line, that's our vent that actually goes around and up in through here. I'm not going to show you that, but there is up there by the filler neck. There is that vent, so all it is are vent hose. Now, we can check to make sure we have the ability or what am I trying to say? We can activate the circuit to make sure that we have enough current amperage to power that solenoid correctly. So I'm gonna pause you up just a second. What are you doing, you knotheads? Yeah, you. I had some visitors right there. Okay, I'm out of little bulbs, so I won't be able to show you an actual light bulb. I'm going to use a test light. This thing only draws a half an amp, and I don't have anything that draws around the same area, so we'll just go ahead, and right now it is venting. Basically, it's neutral position. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn it on to nut venting. And as you can see, that test light lights up. That basically just proves that we are getting power. So off, back on, back off. So I'm not gonna keep doing that. Like, you know what? That's proof enough that the circuit actually does power on. Like I said, it only draws a half an amp, so I'm not going to put a bulb on there that draws potentially two or more amps. May not hurt it, but it may just protect the circuit and kick it off. But in any event, we're not going to go there. Well, we're going to slide this back into place. Get all these extras out of the way. Make sure that is clipped in. You hear a snap. So, whoops, I guess I should have turned the light back on. You hear it snap. We plug back in.
Clip that back in. All right, so give it a tug. Make sure that's everything. Engage it one more time. So we heard the click, so what we can do, well, I'm really not going to get into the scan data and show you the decay or the fuel pressure voltage, sensor voltage, GM 1.5 volts, that's atmosphere. May not be all the cases, but a lot of them are. I've done hooked our smoke machine back up. We shouldn't see any smoke here, but we certainly should see it coming out of here. I don't see it yet, but I can smell it. It does have to fill the system, and hopefully the camera is pointing at it. This is where it's hooked up. This is your vent up there. Hopefully we can see that. So, okay. So we have that. We'll get back into this other area where the canister is, and we'll go ahead and close the system off. Now there is a, this is timed, so bear that in mind. Well, essentially, so fuel tank pressure sensor right now is at 0.3 volts. We don't see any leaks right here. The fuel tank, well, I'll go show you on the scan tool right there. Fuel tank pressure sensor 0.3. So that is responding to our closing of the vent. So I'll give you, let me flip screen so I can see what I'm showing you, or at least what I'm trying to show you. So up here is the business end. So no more smoke pouring out of it right there. You see that vent hanging right there, hopefully. So no more smoke coming out of that. That system is sealed. We can do some further testing. Quite frankly, I don't feel like it. This should be good enough. Like I said, we have response on the fuel tank pressure sensor, so that should be good. And I'm going to go ahead and turn the smoke machine back off because, well, no, exactly that's what I don't want to do. Bear with me there, folks. Oopsie. That was almost a dumb thing that I just about did. I'm gonna climb up the ladder here. I don't have to let it down and then. So, over here on the smoke machine, folks, I'll put that light right there. So, over here on the smoke machine, we can see, hopefully you can see that, 0.10 inches and 0.20 inches. This is set to 20. The large leak is at 20, but our ball, I don't know if you can see it, our ball is nearly all the way down. You know, that'll definitely pass, no problem at all. So this is where the ball really realistically should be. There's going to be a little variance that I've noticed over the years. It's not perfect world, but anyway, show you that part of it, and the system undoubtedly will pass its EVAP test. I'm gonna go ahead and pause that camera back up, get truck back down. Okay, moving on. Now you're gonna want to watch your gauges once you turn everything off, and make sure that it doesn't abruptly pull back down. I've been messing around here for about a good 5 minutes now. I just unplugged my smoke machine, and you could hear the air coming back out of it. So that system is sealed. No ifs, ands, buts about it. No question there. That will definitely pass with flying colors. Fixing to do an EVAP purge and seal on the scan tool. I have to redo that. Actually, I'm not. I'm gonna go ahead and increase this. This is definitely pulling it up, pulling it up, pulling it up, pulling it up. Oh yeah. And it kicked us out because of, well, for obvious reasons, it would collapse the walls on the tank. So before I replaced the purge solenoids, the fuel trims were way up there because the system was reporting lean. Here they are, short term, 0, -3, and long term, short term, -1, -2, -5. You know, it's fine. We had the problem on faint one. This has got to be learned. 10. Well, I don't go all the way to 10. If it stays within 7, I'm okay with it. You know, until this thing fully learns again, that's perfectly fine. We'll give the truck back to the customer. I'm fairly certain that we're not going to see any more problems out of it for right now anyway. So what I do want to see though is you guys hit that subscribe button. Like, dislike, whatever. Leave comments in the comment section. If you liked the video, we'll see you on the next one.